Nikolai, did you forget to walk in class pond?
I don't need to. This one's a watering pot.
What's that?
It's a pot that waters the plants itself. I'll show you.
The self-watering pot is a great addition to any classroom. It allows you to manage the amount of water the plant gets, so it doesn't get too much or too little water.
It prevents mess when watering the plants because when using a hose or watering can, mud can splash on you. It saves water too.
Since the plant and its soil is sitting in a pot made of only laces, the water from the wet laces will travel to the lace connected to it. That lace will wet the lace connected to that one, and the process continues until the whole pot is wet, watering the entire plant.
Now we're going to show you how it works!
The science behind the Swan self-watering pot is that there are two different size laces in different positions.
The thicker lace is placed at the bottom of the pot because the water travels up the lace floor, so it will not have to travel as far. The thinner lace is placed at the top of the pot because the water travels up the lace floor, so it can spread further.
In this case, we will be using the thicker lace.
In this experiment, we put a thin and a thick lace in water. We decided to use blue dye so we could see the progress. We realized that the thin lace absorbed water faster than the thick lace. This process is called cohesion. This helped us to decide on the placement of the laces in the flower pot.
Here's how we made it.
Step 1. First, we weave two sets of laces. Step 2. Then we connected them. Step 3. After we cut the weaved laces to the size we wanted for this pot. Step 4. Then we weaved and attached the base.
Step 5. After that, we attach the laces that soak up the water. Next, we plaited two laces to hold up the water source. Finally, we attach the bottle to the plaited laces.
And there you have it, the Swan self-watering flower pot.